Welcome to the Ripple Effect server. I haven't been on here for a while. Feels good to be back. I have been enjoying playing in 1.14 in my single player world. Too much. But now finally the server has updated too. And we have some fun projects to deal with here. So Marlow has been out and getting bamboo for us all to enjoy. And I thought, let's see, Bank is on, Croc is on. I don't know how many that has been able to play with the new blocks. With bamboo and string, you can make the new scaffolding blocks. By the way, this is how I harvest. If you leave the lowest stem on the ground, it's so hard to pass through it. So this is how I harvest bamboo. Just take it all down and then replant. But anyway, if you have bamboo and string, you can make the scaffolding block. And I thought we could make a little prank here in the spawn area. If we make some scaffolding blocks, there they are. Oh, geez. You know, we will probably never need more than these. So already from that small harvest, we have enough. But let's try something here. If you place it down like this and then continue clicking, it will grow upwards. And then if you go up by holding your jump key, and then place another, it will grow out to the sides like this. Let's make an anvil and see if we can place that. We can. Okay, you probably know what I'm up to. So if we go down now by holding sneak key and we break the lowest block, it all comes down. We make four more anvils and then we make this scaffolding to go all the way to the sky. Now we go up. Ooh, what a view, huh? All right. And then we place blocks in the four directions. Place the anvils. No! What happened? Why did that block break? Okay, maybe these three directions will have to be enough then. Let's switch to wings and hopefully gracefully. Please. Oh, I slept at spawn, didn't I? I was a bit confused there for a while. So this is the post office. Oh, great. So that's just next door. Perfect. So hopefully all my stuff are here. So how does this look now? Okay, you can kind of see it's something up there. This is no good. This is the best place for an anvil, and that is the block that disappeared. Let's see if we can replace that block. Yeah, both Croc and Bank had some trouble flying as well, it seems. Okay, can I... This is the... Okay, it goes out... Oh, no! Oh, sneak! Sneak! Oh! Ooh. Ooh, that was scary. But if you fall like that, you can get back into the scaffolding. And if you hold sneak, you won't take damage. In fact, if you have a too high scaffolding like this, you can fall from any height. As long as you hold the sneak key, you will take no damage. But now we need to go all the way up again. So I guess we can't go out this way. Come on. No. Ooh. Okay, we are at the top again. Let's learn from our mistakes. We go down a bit. Try to place a block. Good. We go out on the dirt block. And then we pillar up the old-fashioned way. And... okay. Now we place another anvil there. And can we place it there as well? Great, because this is the way you will be facing, presumably. Because you are coming from this way into the pillar. And now we'll leave a sign. Okay to borrow, just break bottom block decoy. We'll see if anyone fall for this. Hey Link! But now we're off to Aubyn's place. He has made... what should you say? A game? A quest? How do I get in here? This is the choo-choo train. Oh, here's the entrance that leads to Aubyn's base. Yeah, so he has made a quest. It's really awesome. You need to check his channel out if you don't know what I'm talking about. But he asked me to write some music for that quest. And the first part is kind of a forest. I'll let him explain.
So this first area here is the Arachnid Forest.
Arachnid. Any other group of small animals, similar to insects but with four pairs of legs. That includes spiders, scorpions, ticks, and mites.
So as you can probably guess, and by the fact that it says be careful, it is a cute little forest that is sadly afflicted by the fact that there are a bunch of spiders. Don't see yet, but... well, it kind of failed right now. I was trying to create tension, but... there they are.
A spawner down there?
Yeah. You, come here. Come get me.
Maybe actually, is this a little spoilery, maybe?
Just a little, but not that big of a deal.
You want your paying clients to see this, right? Not anyone for free.
And there's a bit of a cave underneath. So for nice. This, I was thinking, so it's kind of a exploration and a little, like there's a little cave down here too. Cave down here as well. Another spider. Aye. So I was thinking, you know, something kind of a bit of a mystical feel or in a bit of a action soundtrack. So you kind of you explore and you fight monsters and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. So the tension maybe should come already outside then.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is beautiful as well.
Yeah.
But then you know that something is coming.
Yeah, there's kind of something wrong.
This is really disorientating.
I mean, it's going to get even bigger eventually.
Yeah, but if we can find a place where you hear, or maybe they can go in and out of each other, that it doesn't matter if you hear two of them at the same time.
Well, I was thinking just one soundtrack for this whole area, for the whole forest here.
Okay, I see, yeah.
Yeah, the whole thing is a dungeon in itself, the whole forest. So
Okay.
I wouldn't, I won't ask for like two different soundtracks, especially since they have kind of a long range. So
Okay, on that's much easier then.
yeah.
Oh. So I've tried to write music. Maybe this is the entrance that kind of captures the beauty of this forest, but at the same time is a it's mysterious and hints that something is not quite right here. Something is lurking in the shadows. So one part is more calm and lyrical, and the other part is more have more movement, more tension. Aubney messaged me and said he has collected all that I required, and this seems to be it. And this is the area, and we can always expand here, of course, if this isn't enough. Yeah, let's pour up some coffee and get started. So I'm trying a new strategy this time to work with the timings first and where the note blocks will go later. So here we know it will sound. Kind of. And we'll add the note blocks later. That way you get a nice overview. I think it's easier to avoid mistakes this way, but we'll see. And I dug into cobblestone here. That's because the dungeon is under here. So we'll snake back this way. Also, we have a space limitation upwards. This is the ground level. But I think we will fit this, no problem. Let's add the note blocks and tune them and see if I got this first part right. And I think I'll take one instrument at a time. So if you saw, the dirt was always in the middle. That is the harp sound. So if we start with that, I think it will be less confusing. And if you look at the right-hand side, you'll see the numbers going up. That's the note value right there. That's a really nice Java feature. Okay. That's all. Let's see if I got this right. Jeez, the lag. Oh, all of them at the same time. Okay, let's try it again. I've made this wrong. I didn't think about that. This block is just soft powered. It can't lead the circuit off there. So apparently you still can make mistakes. At least I. Okay, let's see now then. Okay, it sounded about right. All the notes were right. The instruments were on the same place. Just a little hard to imagine the tempo with the server lag here, or the lag on my computer, I'm not sure. But yeah, let's keep on working. Spiders everywhere. Okay, this is the end. And this is the start, just to be extra clear. And then Aubney can do what he wants here and make a loop out of it, or make his redstone magic. I've checked it. It sounds okay, but it's so slow. slower than I remembered from my created world. I need to go there and compare, but I don't know if this it is the lag on the server or if it actually is this slow. But I guess you'll have to imagine yourself going through the forest. It's beautiful, but something is not quite right. Kind of slows down there in the end, so the transition back to the beginning is a little bit smoother, and it also fits, I think. So yeah, we'll see what Aubney has to say about this. Maybe we need to speed it up. Aubney seemed to approve, so then I'm happy. I think we'll go to the end now. Work a bit on the minigame. And it has been rebuilt here. Let's enjoy the new view. Marlowe has done an amazing job here. This is so beautiful. I know this is really dark for YouTube, but there is a giant dragon here. Oh yes, baby. We are going up to the minigame area. What does Aubney call it? I never remember. The Moonlight Theme Park, that's it. Most of the redstone is done. We just want to make this kind of connection to all of the tracks. This is when someone wins, the tracks someone hasn't won yet, maybe. Yeah, when someone wins, this torch will turn off, and then the track instead goes back into the starting position. So I need to do that on all the other three tracks, and then I think the redstone is done. I wanted to try something else, actually. Let's switch out the bow for a regular one, because that is what we are going to use later in the minigame. You can't use your own overpowered bow. And now, let's try. How hard is it to actually hit these minecarts? Okay, not too hard. They are standing still though. Okay, so no glitches or anything. Because this is what the game is about, to hit your opponent's minecarts. Yeah, no problem. Let's try it when it's moving. Go. Yeah, you can still hit it. Great! Oh, the redstone here is nasty. But I think I have at least one of the circuits done. So whoever wins, this track will change. So it goes back to the beginning. Let's do some crude testing here. Okay, if green wins, I've set it to just one item. Nothing happened. Oh, I accidentally broke one of the circuits. No wonder then. Okay, now it works. Let's try Red. Great. Yoo-hoo. Yellow. Very good. And blue. Yes. I will do the same thing for the other three players off camera. And then next time we can finally continue building the actual tracks. But now I'm curious to see if anything has happened to our scaffolding trap. It seems to be untouched. Well, we'll leave it up. Maybe someone will fall for it eventually. But thank you for watching this episode, and I'll see you next time.